pictures, and it's everything. It's vaults. It's made out of vaults, and the vaults stand on piers, and the piers use stones from the southern wall in secondary use.
Yeah. Wow.
And you can see the Herodian marge drafts, but.
This is the inside?
This is how it looks inside. This is new. The carpets are new. They made a bridge from, I mean, there's another, like we have the double passage, we have the triple gate passage. We can see it from the southern wall. And there was a wall separating between the triple gate and this structure. And so they made a, they break the wall and started renovating it in 1996. The entrance to Solomon's Tables was until 1996 was from that corner, the southeastern corner. There's a place called the Cradle of Jesus. And it's a place that from the tradition, from the medieval, maybe even earlier, that this was a place that Mary baptized Jesus, baby Jesus. Okay, there's a small entrance, some stairs going down, and this is how people used to go in. It was filled, it was deserted, it was full of debris inside, lots of dirt, dirt heaps. So first they removed the dirt heaps out, okay? Then in 1999, it wasn't enough, that entrance, so they wanted to have a monumental entrance, and they got actually oral, unofficial permission from Israel, actually from the Prime Minister Barak at that time, to open the arch, to open two archways and make an entrance. Now this is an illegal permission, because in Israel, if you want to excavate, if you want to build in an archaeological site, you have to conduct first a salvage excavation in order to document all the archaeological remains at the site. Only then it's released for construction. And in sites like this, usually you preserve the finds. And in 3 days, about 9,000 tons were removed.
How many?
9,000.
9,000
tons were removed from here. And later on, the Israeli police stopped the work over here after they realized the damage that was done. This is why they didn't finish the work. This dirt that was removed out of here.
Who removed the dirt?
First, this was initiative. This initiative was done by the Israeli northern flank of the Islamic movement. It's Israeli Muslims. The Muslim Waqf, which is the administrator of the site, gave permission. But the whole work was carried out by volunteers and by the initiative of the northern flank. And there's they are actually have close relations to the Hamas, and they are funded by the Hamas movement. And today, the head of this movement, I mean, they are connected to the Islamic Brotherhood, because the Waqf is Jordanian, so it's more moderate. But if you look closely, you'll notice that there's some, you can see some sockets, sockets at the top. Yeah,
right.
These are sockets for beams.
Right.
Before, now, I told you that there was an earlier mosque before, at the beginning, and we have a pilgrim, a Christian pilgrim that came to Jerusalem, and he documented the Muslims praying in a very large mosque that could hold 3,000 worshippers with a wooden roof. He says that it was near the eastern wall. So there's a new theory now that over here was the first mosque. The earlier mosque was over here. This was called the Mosque of Jerusalem. This is not a Second Temple period structure. It uses in secondary use.
Okay.
But the royal store that stood here during the Second Temple period, it's collapsed. Everything collapsed through the earthquake, through the destruction. But some of the stones were used in secondary use. There are some stones over there in secondary use, like this stone. You can see some Herodian engravements that appear in the southern wall over here.
It's still there today.
Yeah. But so this structure was actually used from the 7th century till the 11th century. Then it was deserted, and then it was reused when it was opened in the year 1999. And since 2000, Muslims are praying here. They call it Al-Marwani Mosque. And there's some renovation inside, but the main renovation was done over here. In this excavation, all this dirt was removed, I said, and this dirt, I'll explain what this dirt, but soon, but over here you can see some remnants of structures of different stages that were recovered. Some of them were dismantled, and you cannot see them today. But there's probably the wall over there is from the early Islamic period, and this arch is probably medieval or late medieval times, and above here all the stairs are probably from the Ottoman period. All the soil over here, of the dumping, this was not a one-time fill. And this is why we presume today, and also from other, we have also other evidence that the whole eastern area of the Temple Mount was gradually lifted by, it was a dumping site. So soil that comes from over here, it's as a sample. It's a sample from various spots on the Temple Mount. And this is great for us because it means we have a great sample. The information is not specific
just
to this,
for this corner.
To this corner. Okay? And it also means that not much remains were destroyed. Now, we presume that underneath Solomon's tables is another vaulted structure because the mountain walls could not hold so much soil. The bedrock over here is so low, it's about 40 meters lower from the platform over here.
Where did they dump the soil that they took out?
First, over there. Let's go for the first dump, and then we'll speak about the dump.
Place. From where?
The new one. So the soil was removed over here, and then from here it was removed and dumped mainly in the Kidron Valley in an illegal dumping site. Some of it was dumped in a municipal dumping site. There it was mixed with the garbage, and some of it was dumped in another compound in the center of town. We managed to get also that material. And also you can see all this paving. This paving is also new. Mm-hmm. And the level was about half a meter higher. So they also removed this separately. And we could separate that soil from the soil from the pit. But the first stage, they took the heaps of dirt from within the Solomon's tables, put it over here. Later on, they did this excavation, have it over here, and dumped it also. Later on, to the another dumping site, they dumped all the material. You can see the olive trees' roots were exposed.
Yes.
So they lowered the ground over here. And we also have this. They wanted to remove all this soil. They got an approval from the police and from the ticketing authority. But then we petitioned the Supreme Court, and we managed to stop it. And the Supreme Court, it was the first time that the Supreme Court had a ruling that intervened in what's happening in Temple Mount. Usually they prefer not to intervene, say it's too sensitive, it's political.
Yeah.
It's foreign affairs, we cannot interfere in this.
Why did they want to remove it?
But the Supreme Court said if you want to remove it, you have to do it in a control way, and you have to coordinate this.
Yeah.
So they stopped the removal, and since then it's stuck over here. There were some talks about it, but there's so many entities involved in negotiation on how to remove it, so it's impossible. There's about 12 entities that.